you know, I'd see her in the hallway, and it was like she had the spinal fusion, so it was kind of, it was hard to miss her because she was always wearing a neck brace and had her like John Lennon sunglasses on and her like gray hair and like leopard print. And it was just like such a, it was like, this woman is not from Detroit. She stuck out like a sore thumb. It was like, who is this like wild woman?
I've been in Brooklyn as a sculptor for 40 years. Yeah, 40 years. Wow. Yeah, I've been making work for 40 years. Wow.
Prosecco. Did you have a good day painting?
I didn't do anything.
I stopped really being like involved or concerned with what was going on when I turned 60, just like 10 years ago. And if it wasn't for Kevin, I'm not certain I would have a clue, because everybody I knew died. Well, they went on to something else. So all the curators and everybody, my whole milieu was dated. And it was really fabulous that Kevin could come along and take me into the, get me out of the 20th century.
Get her into the 21st. We're still working on that.
Yeah, you got me into the 21st.
We're working on the 21st
century. You got me into the 21st century.
Yeah, we're working on that. At the beginning, it was mostly computer stuff because she's like a Luddite and doesn't know how to like minimize Windows or check. I mean, she knows how to check email. I don't know how she knows how to, but that's like the one thing she can do. So I was always over at Marsha's place. I was just like crashing there and then walking to my studio and then going back and forth. So, because it was really walking distance, I just walked over the Pulaski Bridge and made my paintings and then came home and we'd cook and all that kind of stuff. So, you know, when I wasn't like whoring around the city with, you know, whatever, men. So.
What are we gonna have for dinner tonight, honey? Oh, you don't get your idea. I'm gonna order out.
I have no clue.
There's no way I can make anything.
I don't know if I can.
What is today anyway? Is today Sunday?
Today's Sunday.
And it's October. You can't put this in. I mean, we're like brain dead.
She was like, hey, want to grab a drink with me? And I was like, sure. She's like, how old are you? And I was like, 19. She's like, great, let's get a martini. So then I like, so we go to the bar and we get sloshed. And she kind of convinces me to take Foundry or whatever. I was like, I'm not a sculptor. Like, you know, I'm like, I'm a fucking little Nelly Bottom over here. Like, what am I, how am I supposed to fucking work with metal? Or what? She's like, you know, she's like, well, look at me. You know, I'm a lady. I do it.
Finish the pony. I had a horsewoman finish the pony.
Not see that as like a human dick.
Yeah.
That's not a,
because you know horse dicks. Oh, look at that. What a great job they did. But yeah, we can grind this down even more. All right, great.
We were trying to think of like other painter-sculptor couples where they're both kind of like really like on the same level, maybe. Like, not on the same, nobody's ever on the same level in an artist couple. There's always someone who's more famous, but.
So I haven't been working for 40 years. I mean, I've gotten a lot of press and a whole bunch of catalogs and reviews on that shelf.
She went to all my old studios, but I haven't brought her here yet. Just because I was like, I think it also had to do a lot with the pandemic and us being trapped together for so long that like, even though we've been kind of like, you know, we've been like partners for at least 4 years, it seems like. So, but then during the beginning of the pandemic with, you know, worrying about getting her sick and then her having the hip replacement, it was a kind of pressure cooker of like, holy shit, this is some marital shit. So that was really tough. And I think that I just needed to have a place without her.
When did you guys get married?
Neither of us know.
We can't remember. we're trying to pin that date down. Post-hip operation.
Post-hip operation.
And I could barely walk then. I was still using the walker. Because it was just, I don't know, 2 months after my surgery. We got married during COVID. It was Operation Cupid or something, because nobody could go down to City Hall to get married for quick weddings, so we got married over the internet. The woman, what do you call it, you know, the person who does it, she was very funny, she was very good, and she said, you know, I've done a lot of funny ones in the past few months, but this is actually the funniest. And we were sitting at this table with our Isabel LePere t-shirts on. I wore a lot of my mother's pearls. My mother had a lot of pearls. I had all of these around. I'd taken them out of storage, trying to figure out what the hell am I going to do with them. And it just happened. I had this here, standing here like this. And I thought, wow, Pony's going to go on the walker. And it's going to have a gas mask on it. And that is when my piece really became alive. This has to be finished for NADA in Miami, which is the end of November, early December of the fair there. That's where Kevin and I are showing with LaBeouf. So we've been planning the booth together, how to actually really make an installation out of our work to work. See, this one fits really well, doesn't it? The mules, you know, all the things that saved them. And I became most fascinated with this one. And I decided that the pony was going to have that on it. And that somehow I was going to bring in COVID, not being able to breathe.
I'm working on 4 paintings. This one is done. Blue Bat, which is sort of going off of the paintings that I was making. I was still continuing the series after my first show. And then this new one, which I'm calling the Pale Bat, they could like fall into flying. But that's why their lungs are like really powerful. So they hold all these like, you know, the sort of common cold, you know, coronavirus kind of things that they carry in their lungs are really, really strong because their lungs are really strong for the size of their body. So like if something moves from like a bat to another species, it's usually like really deadly. Marsha and I have not ever shown together. Although Francisco of LaBeouf, Francisco Correa Cordero, he wants to bring both of us to NADA, the New Art Dealers Alliance. So it's a fair that happens alongside Art Basel in Miami. I've never had my work at a fair before. I've only worked at fairs as the help, so that will be interesting. So I think that the way that the booth is going to work is that she's gonna have a wall piece on the back wall, which is actually the teddy that she was in a, she, believe it or not, ran herself over with her own truck, which, don't ask me how that happens. Apparently it's when you are getting your dog ice cream on the way home from the Hamptons that you like park your car and it's in neutral and not in park. And then you decide to be James Bond at 65 years old and jump into a moving truck. And what ends up happening is you slide under the truck and the truck rolls over your body. So that was the sequence of events that led to the piece, which is called Woman with Her Torso Cut, that Marsha made, that is a bronze wall piece that is literally just the teddy that the firemen cut off of her. So it was my idea to put it in because I felt like it really tied our work together. It was the catalyst of us becoming a couple because after the accident, that's kind of how I moved in permanently in the first place, was because I had been kicked out of numerous apartments for various reasons, usually because I deserved it, but,
Hi. Yeah. I'm tracking our dealer. I told him our door is open and the code is 5.
Wow.
Oh my God, so much to talk about.
Oh, I know. so excited.
It's a lot.
All right.
Thank you.
Cheers. Baccarat.
Oh, cheers. Oh,
Baccarat crystal.
Cheers.
From it. From.
Cheers.
What do you
say? They only have seven.
They have seven.
Holy shit.
200 people that want them.
The idea is also to, like, how to leverage that interest with the other artists.
Yeah, I know. Extortion.
Yes.
These art advisors would come in and they'd be super aggressive, like, we'll pay anything for one. Like, they just got, like, really, really aggressive, and they would be sometimes really nasty when you turn them down.
Sorry, I can't
hear that. Dark stories.
Oh, there's plenty of stories already.
I have so many stories, it's as good as
stories.
Yeah.
So pretty.
Coming to Miami with us, I'm so happy.
I'm happy too.
Great gardens, Green Point.
See, you bring the gardens.
I said Marsha brings the gardens, I bring the gray.
Yeah. This is delicious.
This is so delicious. Why is it so good?
How do you do it?
I don't know.
You're gonna tell me it's like that's what it is.
Oh my gosh.
Something like
sorry, that. I'm grossing you out, but that's what he'd say.
It's all about the mouthfeel.
He'd say to me, oh Marsha, it's just like cum. That's why it's so good. All right, Kevin. There's a 39-year age difference.
39-year age difference.
That's really important.
I'm a painter, she's a sculptor. We're getting somewhere.
Okay, so why we're doing this, obviously, well, maybe not obviously, so we can get to the bottom. Take away the penis, we have decided. The horse, I should really talk about that. So the reason I made the dick is, one, I like, well, I have a lot of them in my work, but the shape. You know, it was so great. I wanted to see what a shape was going to be like down there in the negative space. But it changes the meaning. It makes it humorous in a way that I don't want. It's not a funny piece.
I think it's something that she also... sometimes in the way she talks about it, she'll be like more serious than I think that it... Like, she doesn't always effectively communicate the humor that she finds in it, I don't think. Whereas I usually, like, start off with the humor.
So the issue with this is that it's actually the back of a bat skull. And I did this series of paintings. It's not really a series because I only made two, but... But it's something that I know that I'm gonna make more of because it's my like depression series, which hello, that's depression is my best friend, not going anywhere. So, I mean, I know that that'll continue on in some points in my life, but the kind of inside joke for me, which is me being too clever, is that I wanted to make like an expressionist painting about being depressed, which, you know, when you're depressed, you don't have any feeling for expression. So to make an expressionist painting about having no feelings is a ridiculous prospect.
Usually people don't see the humor in mine either, which I think they're really funny. I'm usually trying to make them funny. Or cute. I mean, like, that one's cute. I mean, I put a mustache on it. It's pretty fucking cute.
Well, this is like the eighth dumpster load in 2 days. They keep bringing the dumpsters in and out like a food chain. They keep filling them up with stuff, and we found out yesterday the building is going up for sale. And I've lived in this building more than half of my life. I'm going to be 71, and I've lived here 36 years.
basically. I've just had to fight the landlord for the last 11 years. Every day and every night, millions of dollars, lawsuits constantly. So it's always like an albatross around my neck. It's the only problem, big problem of living here. Like all my friends over the years have said, why don't you just give in, you know, why put up with that? You know, when it was really bad, when it was like really harassing me, which is gonna start again now, I can tell. And I dug in. You know, I love this space. Where am I gonna find a space like this?
Plus the act of somebody trying to bully you, that's not really your style, is it somebody?
No, I'd fight that.
I'm really curious how many other relationships there are like this in New York that's just like a survival thing, because pretty much if you have a studio in New York these days, you've either like found someone who has a great rent deal, you're a rich kid, or I think those are the two. Yeah, I think that's it. Or you do something illegal for money, which, you know, hello, everyone does. So. Not to put that in.
We had decided to get married a year earlier, but we just kept putting it off. That we got married, all my work wouldn't end up in like a 30-yard dumpster, because he's so amazing. He knows it better than anyone, and would kind of take care of it and place it and make things happen. Otherwise, I would die, and that would be it. This is the only waterfront development left in Greenpoint. Everything else is taken up. I mean, he waited and waited the right time. It's the last bastion on the waterfront. That's it. There's nothing else to say. It's been a horrible thing to live with, but I'm still here. I'm still here. Look like it's the hair. Just this little puppy.
You want to leave this one?
Oh my God. Yeah, leave that one and just do this little one. Look at how good this looks.
Yeah, the handles,
looks so
good. The handles are a lot better.
The handles are... Do this at the end of every work day.
No. It's usually a lot less glamorous. I'm usually catatonic and I just lay down in my coffin. Call it a day.
Well,
okay.
Cheers.
Cheers.
To Miami.